I am Colin Hill. I'm a professor in the Department of Radiation Oncology and also the chair of the Radiation Safety Committee. And I'm making a small presentation this morning to help you understand the use of the new XRAD 9 irradiator. This machine is designed specifically to do three things. One is irradiate small animals and cell tissue culture with 250 kbps X-rays, but it also has variable energy. The second is that you can actually collimate the size of the field. So you can irradiate different sized animals or different sized flasks. The third is that you can change the dose and the dose rate by moving the shelf and so on. Most of you have probably been using the cesium irradiator that's presently in the Norris Cancer Center and has recently been decommissioned. That machine uses cesium-137 gamma rays. By definition, 250 kVp X-rays, which is the standard energy we're going to use on the new X-ray machine, has an RB of 1. Cesium gamma rays are very close to 1. So you should have no fear in moving experiments or studies you've been doing on the irradiator in the Norris Cancer Center to the X-ray machine if you continue to use 250 kVp X-rays. If you want to do something different, like a shallow surface irradiation, we can change the energy for example, 50 kVp X-rays, which will only penetrate very little into the skin. By definition of the ICRP, the RBE of both of these is 1. The cesium-137 gamma rays have a higher energy, but their biological effect is very similar. There are a few reports of much higher doses of an RB of 1.1. For most studies that you're going to be doing on this machine, we're going to use an RB of 1. This particular machine has some big advantages over the old irradiator. In particular, it's computer controlled. And then second, in order to use this machine, you have to get permission to use, and that is very similar to the previous permission protocol for the irradiator. You have to have an approved radiation safety protocol through the regular channels. But we've added one more layer here. You must be trained on this particular machine by a radiation safety officer. And once you're trained, your actual ID badge will be used to give you access to both the building and the room in which the irradiator is kept. This is a security issue, so that we can only have people who are trained actually using the machine. We have also set up on the radiation safety website an X-irradiator calendar where you can actually book time on the machine so that people are not trying to use it at the same time. When you go to the machine on the computer, you will have a login and password that allows you entry to the machine. And last, once you've got access to the machine, the particular doses in your protocol will be programmed into the machine, so that when you log in, you'll have access just to those programs, so there won't be any chance of using the wrong doses or the wrong energies. When you come into the room, the first thing you're going to do is turn on the machine. And you'll also notice there's an emergency stop button. That would allow you to stop the machine at any point during the irradiation if a problem occurs. When the irradiation's on, there are two lights that come on. The other light here and another light up top. Alright, once initialization is complete, you'll see it comes up and asks you for a username and password. Usernames are already entered, so you press the and it brings up a list. You just find your name in the list, and then you need to enter your password. This is all touch screen, so you touch and it brings up and you can put in your password. Once you've got both in, you press continue, and that brings you to the program. If you are a standard user, you'll only have access to the recall program, and you'll click on that, and that will show you the programs that you have access to. And at that point, you would pick one of the programs that you want to use, and press continue, and now it asks you to wait while it sets up the program. If we want to stop in the middle of a dose, we can press X-ray stop.
or when it reaches 300, it will stop automatically. I'm going to stop it so we don't have to wait. And if I want to exit this particular program, I press exit. It will ask me if I really want to cancel the exposure, I press exit again, and takes me back to the program. If I want to get out of the program, I will press exit or continue, depending on what I'm doing here. If I want to finish, I press exit. If I choose a new program, I press continue. So I'm actually going to exit and just leave it at that phase right now. Now, if we open the door, this is a heavy lead door, so it's a good idea to use both handles, so you're not putting a lot of stress on this catch. Okay? It has an interlock up here. The interlock is for your safety. It will not allow the x-rays to be on when you open the door. So it automatically turns off x-rays if you open the door during an exposure. Inside, there are three important aspects to this. First is the filter. Most of the people are using 250 kDp x-rays, and they will be using this filter, filter F1, which is actually 2 millimeters of aluminum. And that filter actually goes in this slot. When you push it in, the last quarter of an inch, it snaps. It's important that you go that all the way in. If you don't, part of the filter holder is actually blocking the exposure. The second thing is the shelf. The shelf is set at 50 centimeters. That's 50 centimeters to the surface of this plastic sheet, to the source. That determines the dose rate at the exposure surface. So we've set it at 50 centimeters for irradiation of small mice, mouse pups, and cell cultures in flasks. If you're using something thicker, then you need to talk to one of the radiation safety officers or to me in the radiation safety committee to discuss adjusting the dose, because the dose falls off with the distance from the source. Okay? So for example, if you were going to put something rather large in here and the exposure surface is here, the dose rate would be much higher and therefore the dose on it would be incorrect. The dose is calibrated for this particular point right now. If you look inside here, you can see a fairly large lit window. This lit window can be adjusted and is normally set at 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters. And I'll bring it down to that size using the X and Y knobs on the collimator. This is the standard field size that we've done dosimetry for. If you can fit your exposure flask or dish in there, you will get the dose that's prescribed on the program. If you are hanging out into the shaded area, you're not getting exposed. So in that case, you would need either to increase the size of it, which means actually talking to one of the radiation safety officers, because we have to measure the dose rate in the area that you're going to increase it to. For special programs, we have a 20 by 20 field. This field can go as small as 1 centimeter and as large as 20 by 20 at 50 centimeters source to surface. This is the collimator that adjusts that. This is the switch that turns the light on and off. Generally leave the light on so you can see that you're actually in the field of irradiation. The collimator actually can be moved, and it's a good idea to check that it's centered. So there is an actual plate here that shows a little X. The collimator has a crosshair, and you can tell if the whole thing is properly square by matching the crosshairs with the X. Once all of that is ready, and you put your sample in, I'm going to use the ruler as a sample. It doesn't actually fit, but that's fine. We then close the door. And at that point, when you go back in, if we now go back into recall program, and I'll call back a program that's more typical. This is 250, number 13. This is 250 kDp, which is the standard that most people are using. See, it says error, door control 1 and 2 open. because I have the door open, I now have to tell it that I've closed the door. So I'll clear that, and then it's now compiling the dose for that particular program. And now it's showing that program ready. If I'm sure everything is set up correctly in here, I can press start, and it will now come on, hopefully. We've got a clear error again. And I clear it, and I press start, and this time it stays on. And this time we should see the appropriate dose increase. After a few seconds, it actually shows you the dose rate on this one. This is the total dose. That's the dose you're trying to get to. If I want to repeat a dose, I've already done one dose. I just have to remove my original sample, put in my new sample, so I'll use the filter, close the door, and just press start again. So again, this shows you the dose rate, and this shows you the total dose. This shows you the dose that you're trying to get to, and this is the amount of time that's elapsed. And it will stop automatically. It has actually an ionization chamber built in here that's measuring the dose for you. And that's been calibrated against a standard chamber that we use for actually calibrating the machine at least once every 6 months. You see now it shows x-rays off, the light has gone off. Your dose is very close to the dose you asked for. Okay? When you're finished now, you would press exit. You press exit again. And if you're finished with everything, you press exit here. That brings you back to the first page. And at that point, you can actually turn off your radiator. And you'll hear the screen will go blank, and that will eventually stop. Don't worry about this continuing to make a noise. It actually is a cooling unit that's cooling the oil that cools the generator. That will go on for another 10 or 15 minutes after you're finished. So long as you've gone to off, you're clear to go. Now, do remember, however, after you use, it's good to return this to the way it was when you arrived. Clean, filter in place, the right size seal, which is 10 by 10. If you are using a special field or a special position, please put it back to the standard set of conditions. At that point, you're pretty much clear. I think that's it.
Once you have your key card activated, that actually allows you to get into the room. It also allows you to get into the elevator to come down to here. And at night time, it allows you to get into the building. So when you actually get it activated, if you're going to do work after 5 o'clock, you need to make sure to ask them to give you activation for the building, because the building is secured at 5 o'clock every day.